Hey guys, this is Dow Phoenix, and this is a video where we're going to talk about Sega's big announcement on January 16th. So depending on when you're watching this video, that's either tomorrow, today, or maybe it's already happened and you just happened to just see the video just now. So obviously this video is recorded before the big announcement, needless to say. But what is that announcement exactly? There's a lot of people on Twitter, Facebook, and so on that are excited for new Sega games like Phantasy Star Online 2 and Shenmue 1 and 2 HD Remaster and all kinds of other crazy things like that. But let's be realistic, guys, here. Don't get your hopes up too much. Let's temper your expectations because Sega gave us a lot of hints and this is what we'll probably end up seeing. So let's take a look at it. Okay, so let's rewind a little bit to January 12th. On Facebook and Twitter, Sega simply sent a picture of a green background with a light bulb saying 16th January. The timing was very impeccable because this was literally one day after Nintendo's mini direct, which of course there was a lot of hype over that, naturally. So a lot of people thought that this was going to be a huge announcement, maybe something coming to the Switch, possibly. But one thing that people really hung on to was the light bulb that was used in this particular image. Now, what significance does a light bulb have? Well, of course, they're used to make lights, so some people obviously joked, hey, maybe Sega's getting into light bulb making, right? I mean, because, you know, why not? But no, seriously, light bulb means Sega Institute. Now, why is that a big deal? I mean, most people probably have no idea who the hell Sega Institute is. Well, Sega Institute made a huge fan favorite game that people have adored back on the Sega Genesis. That game, of course, is Comic Zone. Now, Comic Zone is a fantastic and fun game, and I would love a new Comic Zone because wouldn't that just be awesome, guys? I mean, that was one of the best games on the Genesis, in my opinion. It is ridiculously hard, but I have been able to legitimately beat it in the past, and of course, nowadays, thanks to the convenience of save states, you don't even have to legitimately beat anymore. You just save state and just keep at it until you win, of course, which is great. Good times indeed. But anyways, no, it's not a new Comic Zone. Come on, don't be ridiculous. I mean, it's been over 20 years and that franchise is pretty much dead. I don't think it's ever been a franchise, sadly, but I think we can go ahead and cross that one off the list. Now, let's go ahead and talk about, well, what about a Shenmue 1 and 2 remaster? A Shenmue 1 and 2 remaster would be awesome as well. But let's face it, guys. The team that's working on Shenmue 3, if there is going to be any kind of remaster, I'm sure it's going to have their blessing. And since Sega wouldn't even publish their game, I mean, come on. I mean, who even knows who owns a Shenmue franchise? Does Sega even own it? I don't know, guys. I think maybe they no longer have access to that. So I think we should cross that one as well. And then, of course, another one I hear a lot. Phantasy Star Online 2. I mean, because Sega has promised us game for years, and it's never came to fruition. I mean, we would love to have some Phantasy Star Online 2. I know I would, because Phantasy Star Online was one of the best games on the Dreamcast, and I also played it on the original Xbox. Fun game. But I mean, come on, guys. Japan's seen this game like, what, 6 years ago? At this point, I would be like shitting my pants if that is what we saw. So let's just cross that one out as well. Okay, so that doesn't really leave us a whole lot of indication based on what we've seen from Sega. Here's the thing. The answer's been right in front of us for quite a long time. Actually, some information that was revealed before Sega even has told us exactly what this will probably be, or at least what it will likely be. So let's go ahead and dive into that. Okay, so the first hint is the second image that we just saw today sent out by Sega. We see the light bulb again, but it says TWO Morrow for tomorrow, which also tells us, well, hey, maybe the number two could mean it's a sequel of some kind. A sequel to a game that we only got one of, which I guess is probably why some people thought Comic Zone, but come on. Now, that is all good and fun. That image is pretty much the same, but there is a particular little thing that we see on the bottom left corner of the image that is of real importance here. This is what actually gives us a real indication of what we can expect. You might see a little icon that says 2 point on it. It looks like a little mountain. What exactly is that? What is 2 point exactly? I mean, if you go online, you really can't find much information. But essentially, 2 point is a brand new game studio that just recently started back in 2016. That's headed by some people that formerly were part of Lionhead and Bullfrog Productions. In other words, they're people that were responsible for making various games such as Fable, Black and White, the movies, Theme Hospital, so many more games, right? I mean, there was a ton of games that they were responsible for. I think that the particular people they mention in the articles, a lot of times they mention Theme Hospital, Black and White. So I guess the people that are heading this may have had some heavy involvement with those particular games. So knowing that, and also knowing Sega's rich history in the past few years when it comes to PC gaming, I think it's going to be something that's going to be related to that, honestly. I mean, Sega, when you think of Sega, I mean, you think of like classic games like Golden Axe and Streets of Rage. You think of Sonic the Hedgehog, naturally. You think of Yakuza. I don't think it's going to be anything to do with Sonic. I don't think it's going to be anything to do with Yakuza. I don't think it's going to be anything to do with a classic Sega franchise whatsoever. I think it's going to be a strategy or simulation game. I think that's important to note because Sega has made a lot of ground in the past few years in that segment. As a matter of fact, they are one of the top publishers right now on the PC market when it comes to those type of games. They put out games like Total War. They put out the new Dawn of War games, Warhammer, of course. They put out Football Manager, which is like one of the most popular sports simulation games. They put out all kinds of games like that consoles frankly never see, or if they do, it's very, very rare that they ever see these kind of games. So I think those are pretty important to note because those are, besides Sonic, probably Sega's biggest money earner, if you think about it. I mean, yeah, you got Yakuza in Japan, but, I mean, that's just in Japan. I mean, we do have it here in the States, but it's a very niche title. I would be really shocked if Yakuza outsells any of these PC games, even Football Manager. That would really surprise me, honestly. But anyways, I think it's something to do with that. However, if we delve even further, we probably have a good indication of exactly what we can expect. So here is an interesting trademark filing that recently popped up on the internet a few days before Sega first tweeted this news. And you'll notice that it says 2 point hospital. Okay, so what's that exactly mean? 2 point hospital. So this is something that was trademarked by this particular company for a game. Now, it is entirely possible that this game that Sega's teasing tomorrow may be unrelated at all to this. But I think it is very important to note that it does say 2 point on the bottom left corner of that particular Sega advertisement. So maybe there's a second game. After all, they did say tomorrow. Maybe 2 point is working on two games. I am firmly in belief that one of those games is 2 point hospital. And that's because, well, I mean, that's just the writing on the walls. I mean, if we just look at the evidence, guys, that's what we see. We don't see evidence for anything else. Maybe it's a complete ruse and we're going to see something that we really want to see. Unless, I don't know, maybe if you're a fan of Theme Hospital, maybe you really want to see this game. Theme Hospital was a pretty decent game after all. I mean, I was more of a theme park fan myself because I like amusement parks and things like that. But I think that's kind of what we can expect out of this. But color me shocked, of course, if we do get a huge surprise that this particular teaser completely thrown us off the loop for. But let me know what you guys think, of course. Heck, you know, by the time you watch this, maybe it's already been revealed. So let's just kind of discuss in the comments about what Sega revealed and are you satisfied with it or not? But anyways, till next time, down Phoenix out.